Give me your hand as we pray together. We get weak. We get so weak at times.
But you know he's always there. Every step we take, you know he's one ahead of us. He's clearing that way for us.
That's
we
right.
just have to hold on and believe and trust.
Yes.
And I tell you what, my faith's been tested a lot here lately. But thank God,
yes.
I'm holding on.
Yep.
I'm holding on yes. to the best thing I've ever found.
Yes.
Hallelujah,
yes.
the best thing. Thank
yes.
you, Lord. Thank you, Lord. In my church family, I thank y'all all because I have no doubt y'all have really been praying for us, this whole family. And I tell you what, I appreciate it because I can feel there's times I've been down and I get a text from Jenny and she just say, just thank you, Matthew. Or Lana called, you want to go walk? And I say, thank you, Lynn, yes. So I just thank God for y'all. And y'all just always been there for us. Thank you, Lord.
Praise God.
26.
Thank you.
long she'll get in our Sunday mornings, and she'll say, "Poppy, let's practice."
Amen.
And she'll start singing this song with him.
Praise the I don't know if we've got colony. Amen. I come, you know, when you miss a week of church, even though we're on vacation, you miss it. Amen. And no matter how many devotionals you read and videos you watch, there's nothing like being there.
That's right.
So, but all I can keep thinking about at this time is the new year.
Amen.
And you. That's what God kept showing me while I was on vacation, when I would read, it is new. And before we can go to new,
come on,
we got to come out of the old.
Amen.
Amen.
And I guarantee you, everybody in here has got something they want to come out of. How many people, and I want you to raise your hand. Like I said, the camera can't see, don't worry about it. How many people in here has some stuff this past year that you're ready to come out of?
Come on.
I don't want to be there anymore. You ain't gonna move till you get sick and tired of being where you at.
Come on.
And you know what? If we'll be honest, some of us moved out of that place last year, or year before last, let me go back.
Bless the Lord.
On this same New Year message, I'm moving out of it, but somewhere during the last year, you brought it with you.
Come on.
Or you went back and visited it. Let me tell you what, when God brings you out of something, it ain't meant for you to go back and visit it.
Amen.
That's right.
Amen. I'm just going to be honest this morning. You ain't got no purpose back there.
There's nothing there anymore.
If there was, God wouldn't have brought you out of it.
Amen.
That's right.
Amen. That's what we need to hear. There ain't no summer vacation going back to what God delivered you out of. When you are delivered out of something, you are set free out of its grasp, and you are not meant to go back.
That's right.
Amen.
Praise God.
But you hear me now. You ain't strong enough.
Come on.
There's some stuff in your life you ain't strong enough to go back to.
Amen.
I don't care how long you've been saved. I don't care how many devotionals come to your phone every morning. I don't care how long you pray. I don't care how many Christian shirts you got hanging in your closet. I don't care what the tag on your car says. Some stuff you are not meant to ever go back to, because it will always have something that will hold you longer than you want to stay there.
Amen.
That's right.
Amen. And there'll always be a part of you that compels you to go back.
Amen.
Let me tell you, let me go ahead and clarify that. That ain't God.
That's right.
I don't serve a backwards God. I don't serve a God that's got a rear view mirror this big and want you to go back from what He's already delivered you from.
Amen.
We got to get that in our heads. Amen. There's something in you that's called the flesh. You can call it whatever you want. The devil, yourself, whatever. There's something in you that will compel you to go back to a place that you don't belong.
That's right.
You've got to decide.
Even to remember it. That's right.
You've got to decide, I'm not going back.
Come on.
That place is done.
That's right.
I'm going to read just a few. I'm just one right now. You'll find this in the book of Exodus. Chapter 14. Get there and say amen.
Amen.
I'm giving you a back story. I'd encourage you to go back and read it. Probably everybody sitting in here has read it.
Amen.
The children of Israel, he went down there, Joseph went down there because God sent him there. It took a lot of good and bad circumstances to get him to where he was at. Then he provided for his family. He was allowed to bring them down. And they prospered. And the Bible says that when the Pharaoh died, the other ones didn't remember him as much. So it started to go from good to bad. Amen?
Yeah.
We've all been in a place that was good, it was good, it was good, then it went bad. Alright, then God said, okay, I got to get y'all out of here.
You prayed.
Your prayers have went up and up and up, and finally they've come into my presence. And let me tell you what, I don't care what anybody tells you, when your prayers get into the presence of my God, and I hope your God, He's going to do something about it.
Amen.
Amen. And if your God don't, you better be swapping Him in.
That's right.
No better time than a new year. this day ain't a God that can't help me.
Woo!
Ain't a God that's a God I don't need.
That's right.
Greg, when everything in me wants to go back, I thank God for a God that won't let me.
Amen.
Amen.
When the things that he's done on this side out compared to the things that were on the other side, let me tell you what, I ain't got nothing to go back to.
Amen.
That includes this year. Ain't nothing for me in last year. Last year was a good year. Amen?
Yes. Amen.
I'm standing here this morning still alive. I still saved. My name still wrote in the book of life. It was a good year.
Come on. Yeah.
Oh, but this one.
That's right.
See, I can't get this year's stuff last year.
That's right.
Amen? But I got to get out of last year. I got to leave my failures. Can I get amen?
Amen.
I got to leave the things that I messed up. Amen. Hey, so what if it's a big steaming burning pile over there, Greg? I just got to forget it.
Come on, come on.
And move on, because now I've got a new year. God said, you know what? The priors have come up here. I got to get them out of there. So he set a bush on fire, drawed a man in, said, hey, I need you to go over there and bring them out.
That's right.
See, if he hadn't tried something new, he wouldn't have been the one to bring them out.
Amen.
Going into this new year, it ain't got to make sense.
That's right.
No, it don't.
You ain't got to figure it out.
That's right.
See, we want certainty before we do something. Can I get amen?
Yeah.
I'm going to pray about it. I'm going to get you to pray about it. I'm going to wait it out. I'm going to see if the stars align. If I go out there and there's 3 drops of rain on my hood and 4 on the ground, I'm going to go for it. God, no, you ain't got to figure it out. If God's already got a plan, all we got to do is follow it.
Amen.
You want to know how to succeed in this year? Just listen to God. So I'm going to close it up and stop right there.
Amen.
Quit trying to figure it out. Quit trying to throw your 2 cents in there.
Well, right, we mess it up.
I said it last year, Miss Diane, and I'll start off this
Amen.
Year saying that God didn't call you to think.
That's right.
Amen.
Your gift in the Spirit is not thinking.
Exactly.
Praise the Lord.
Thank
you,
Lord.
Yeah, if her gift was thinking, all of us would be doomed, and everybody around us.
That's right.
Because her thinking is changed by what the TV says.
Ooh, yeah.
It's changed by what somebody says, changes by the whatever flashes up on your phone,
yep.
Whatever's happening in the market. But you know what? God don't care. God's word don't change to none of that. Amen.
No, it doesn't.
He told him, he said, bush is burning, but it is not consumed. I got to figure out what that is. The Bible said he turned in and God began to speak to him. Hey, God already had a plan. And if
Amen.
God had a plan all those years ago, amen, to get them out from where they were, God's already got a plan to get us out
Amen.
Before we are.
That's right. He's going to help us.
So he went. I love the fact he made excuses.
Mm-hmm.
But I love even more the fact that God had answers.
Oh, he did.
Amen. For every excuse he gave, God had an answer.
Yes, he did.
Let this be the year that we give up the excuses and go
right.
with God's answer.
Praise God.
Realize that it ain't my wisdom. Thank you, Lord.
Amen.
It ain't my knowledge. It ain't my ability. And it ain't yours. It's all what God's already done.
Amen.
Thank you, Lord.
See, I love that. He didn't have to sit down. Well, let me see how I'm going to get them out of here. First of all, I'll do this and then this. I'll make me a checklist, an outline, whatever you want to do. He didn't need that.
No, he didn't.
God said, all you need to do is what I tell you to do.
That's right.
You want to know how you're going to get out of this year? What God has in store for you this year, do what God said.
Amen.
Do it His way.
Praise God. Thank you, Lord.
So he went, and he stood before Pharaoh, and God worked many wonders.
He did.
To get him out.
He did.
I want you to take a second and recollect on the wonders that God did in this past year to get you to now. See, right now, we stand at a threshold of a new year. And it's up to you what you're going to do in it. See, God's already got a day planner for all 2022. He's got one for me. He's He's got one for you. Whether you want it or not. And Greg, my God don't wake up every morning and pencil something in.
No, he doesn't.
He's already got mine filled out. Because he already knows his plan. He knows his plan from the beginning.
Amen.
And he knows the plan for you.
He does.
But if I don't show up, if I'm flipping through 2021's calendar, I ain't going to see what's on 2022. You know, all that heartbreak, all that stuff, leave it.
Amen.
Leave it.
Yes.
It's a new year. That person that did you wrong last year, hey, just believe they won't do you wrong this year.
That's right.
We say it all the time. We speak things into existence.
Amen. You know? We do.
Amen. Last night, one of my kids, I don't call their names, they get mad at me sometimes. The tornado sirens was going on the radios and stuff. Like, is a tornado coming? I said, ain't no tornado coming.
Oh,
that's right.
Bless you.
Said, how do you know? I said, I know I can speak it.
Amen. Come on.
I can just as easy say it is, or I can say it ain't, and I'm going to say it ain't.
That's right.
That's right.
See, we got to realize that the power that we possess in the words we speak.
Amen. Praise God.
That dictates where you're going.
It does.
In this new year.
Amen.
It does.
If you've been negative, stop it. Now, it ain't going to be instant.
Come on.
You ain't going to say, I'll never be negative again. It never happened. No, but you can catch yourself.
Amen. Praise God.
Amen. Somebody can remind you. Amen. Just like when we were going on vacation, somebody sent Jenny a text and used my own words again. Amen. Says my anger worketh not the righteousness of God. And I won't say who sent it. They know who they are. Amen. See, knew I was going to be driving. Knew that that's what gets me in trouble. So guess what? She went ahead and put it out there. We speak those things. We joke about it. And ain't nothing wrong with that. But the words that come out of your mouth,
come on,
frame what's going to happen in your life. See, we can already begin to frame how great this year is going to be.
Amen.
I've already started it, Greg. I've already started it not only for me and my family, but for this church, for every member of Daily Walk Ministries. I've already begun to frame how great a year this is going to be in the kingdom of God for us. So he went and he spoke all the things, and guess what? Everything that he said, hear me now. Everything that he spoke, God did it. When he said, hey, river's going to turn to blood, guess what? God said, there it is. Locusts are coming, there they are. But I love the fact he always provided an out.
Amen.
Yes, he did.
For the children of Israel.
For us too.
Hey, we've been grafted in. We've been adopted. We're provided a way out of everything. So, come time to go. I love the fact, man, that when they rolled up out of Egypt, that they even give them gas money, believe
me. Yeah, they did. All the gold.
God said, you ain't going to leave empty-handed. You're going to take some stuff with you. They're going to pay to get rid of you.
Amen.
Amen. I know everybody in here would pay to get rid of somebody, or there's a lot of people pay to get rid of us. Let's be honest. You know what? God can use whatever.
Amen.
See, God can use your worst enemy to bless you. He can use the thing that's trying to destroy you to prosper you. Because he's God. And he has that ability. So they got all their stuff and they headed out. And God guided them by day and by night. As long as they were looking, they could see where they were going. Then old Pharaoh and them got to thinking about it. Man, I let all my free labor go.
Yep.
And they got all my money.
Yeah.
Now I'm going to go out here and make my own stuff. We're going to go get them back. See, the world may change its mind.
Amen.
God don't.
Yeah. That's right.
said you're going out. See, I come to tell somebody this morning, last year's over, you're going out. No matter what the world tells you, no matter what you tell yourself, you're going out. You need to change your thinking and change your speaking, because whatever's in here and whatever's in here comes out here. Bible says out of the abundance of the heart, your mouth will speak. So Pharaoh and them, they begin to chase it. And they saw it. And God made like a fog between them. We'll read right here. Verse 10. I'll start at verse 10. Everybody there?
Amen.
Exodus 14. Chapter 10.
10.
Chapter 14, verse 10, sorry. And when Pharaoh drew nigh, the children of Israel lifted up their eyes, and behold, the Egyptians marched after them. And they were sore afraid. Somebody this morning, probably more than one, probably a whole lot more than one, if we'll be honest. We're right on the brink of it.
Yep.
But what has been holding us back, or what has been stopping you or hindering you or whatever words you want to use, is still there. And it's trying to catch up to you. And you can see it. But God, hey, the same God that can tell the water how far it can come. It's the same God that can look at your problems or whatever it is stalking you and tell it you can only go this far.
That's right.
But see, when we get our eyes off God and begin to look back, see, if they would have kept looking forward, what was ahead of them? There was a pillar of fire and a cloud guiding them. That was God. If we're looking ahead at God, I ain't got time to look at what's coming up behind me. Bible says that God will guard that. Does it not?
Amen.
It does.
Said he'll guard my back. All I got to do is look forward. And if I'm following God, if you want to work for this year, it's look closer at God and quit worrying about what's behind you.
Amen.
There ain't nothing behind you that's beneficial to your walk with Jesus. Oh, but when we stop, and we all do it, we stop and begin to look back at the things that's had a hold of us. Can I get amen? And when we begin to look back, fear starts to come in. And the Bible says, God has not given me a spirit of fear. If you have fear, it is not from God.
That's right.
Amen. It says perfect love casts out what?
Fear.
There ain't no fear in God.
No fear in God.
There's a reverence fear.
Amen.
A respectful fear. But not, I got a tower in the corner because I'm scared to death of him, fear. That's my daddy. And right or wrong, I can still run and get in his arms.
Amen.
But they were looking back, and they were afraid. And the children of Israel cried out unto the Lord, and they said unto Moses, because there were no graves in Egypt, hast thou taken us away to die in the wilderness? Wherefore hast thou dealt thus with us to carry us forth out of Egypt? Now we like to, anybody else like to read this and think, man, them dudes is idiots.
They are.
Can I get amen?
Yep.
We've all done that, right?
Yep.
Until we realize that we act the same way.
Yes, we do.
Amen? We think that they missed all of this, yet we're still, how many people in here, raise your hand, don't be ashamed. How many people in here are still, something's got a hold of you that you're afraid of, that you've been delivered from, that you've been set free from, that still can draw your attention away from God? I don't care if it's a quick glance over the shoulder to look back at it, when you know what, we got no right doing that.
So
that's
right.
Every one of you. You didn't raise your hand, you probably do.
Yeah.
It ain't got to be some big, great, scary thing. It could be something little.
Yeah.
But see, once we take our eyes off God, we begin to look back. And then, you ever thought, I wonder if I'm even saved? I hit a home run with that.
Yeah.
God even want me to do this.
There you go.
I'd have been better off, Miss Diane, if I'd have just stayed where I was at.
Said it a million times.
Stinking church, I should just stay home. Amen? And automatically the fear takes over. We look back, and this is what kills me, and I'm talking to myself this morning. We look back at those things, and somehow we think in our mind that we had to overtake it to begin with. When God done it all along. I was scared of it the first time, Greg, when he destroyed it. And I didn't have to do nothing but trust in God and keep my eyes on him and do what he said.
Amen.
And you know what? If I look back at it again, I lose sight of God and how powerful he is.
No.
And then, when we begin to doubt God, don't everybody look around because you've all done it. We quickly lose sight of how powerful he is. Amen? And we catch ourselves singing a song just because everybody else is. We don't realize it when you listen to the words of some of those songs. The power.
Amen.
Amen? Hey, I'm here to tell you, when we speak it, when we believe it, when I keep my eyes focused on God, you ever been so close to God that you felt like you could do anything? See, that's when you're focused on him and him alone. Let this be the year that we don't look back.
Amen.
Let this be the year that we leave what was behind us so far behind that we can't get back. Amen. I like how God separated the Red Sea and took them across on dry land. But what happened when they got on the other side? See, now, he may have released that water to kill Pharaoh and them, but I believe he released that water also to keep them from going back, amen? Because without God, they wouldn't have got across it. But he made a way, then he shut the door. I thank God this morning that I serve a God that will shut a door, amen? He'll stop me from going back, Greg, even if I wanted to.
Come on, amen.
They said, Moses, what have you done? What have you done? I love how we blame other people for our problems. Can I get amen?
Yay!
I love how it's always somebody else's fault. That I'm in the shape I'm in because of so-and-so. No. You're in the shape you're in because of you. You're in the shape you're in. Hey, I ain't breaking no hearts this morning. I'm just telling you. We get in the shape we're in because we spend time looking back on things that we didn't have no right to look back on. How many of you ever walk around backwards all the time? I get on to Cody all the time. We'll be out and he'll just be, I said, son, turn around, you're going to run into something. You may make it for a while, but sooner or later you're going to trip, you're going to fall, you're going to run into something, you're going to get hurt. We ain't made to walk backwards. We're made to look ahead. Amen, to where God's taking us. Whether you believe it or not this morning, in 2022, God is taking you somewhere this year.
Amen.
That you've never been.
That's right.
Now, you can accept that or not, I don't care. I'm just going to say what God told me to say. Verse 12 says, is not this the word that we did tell you in Egypt, saying, let us alone that we may serve the Egyptians, for it had been better for us to serve them than that we should die in the wilderness? Hey, I thank God this morning that he don't leave us alone.
Amen.
That he don't gain, that he don't give us what we want, that he don't give us what we think we need. Man, a lot of us in bondage right now.
Come on.
Oh, but I like this. I read all that just to get to this. I told y'all three scriptures, but I lied. And Moses said unto the people, fear ye not.
Amen.
Fear ye not. In other words, look up here where there's life. Look ahead. There ain't no fear in looking ahead. There's only fear in looking back.
Amen.
Stand still.
Amen.
I'm going to say that again. Stand still. Quit running around like a chicken with your head cut off. Quit running around trying to be busy.
That's right.
Quit trying to run around and be religious. religious.
Uh-huh.
Quit trying to run around and fit in.
That's right.
Quit trying to run around and do what you think you should be doing. There comes a time when we need to just stand still. If we don't stand still, sometimes we miss what God's trying to tell us to do. Amen? How many of you ever thought you were lost in the woods? Anybody in here? They say that when you think you're lost, in the first 5 or 10 minutes, you get 3 times more lost than you did to begin with. Because they think, well, just over this ridge, and you'll run and you start making bad decisions. When if you just stand still sometimes and look.
Amen.
Now see, we all think, how many people in here, well, I know the Bible says we ain't, but a lot of us in here think sometimes we got counselors. Amen. I tell by the last, I ain't the only one. That we tell God this and that and what he's going to do and what he needs to do, and he actually listens. We're running around trying to do all this stuff and we forget
that he's the one.
That he's the one. And he had a plan from the beginning.
Yes, he did.
See, I believe he was telling them, look, if you'll stand still and look here, quit running around, because, hey, you imagine there was millions of people. Some people said, what, 6-7 million crossed over? Depends on what you read. Imagine that many people running around scared.
Yep.
Most of them wanting to go back. Most of them wanting to go forward. He said, look, stand still. Stop. Just stop.
Amen.
If there's a word, another word for a day, just stop. You're what, 3 days into this new year? Stop. Look around. How many times, and you gotta raise your hand, how many times when we're putting up our New Year's resolutions or whatever you want to call them, I ain't talking about going to the gym and losing 30 pounds. I'm talking about in your walk with God. I hope everybody in here at New Year's, you come up with something. How many times have we ever just stopped?
Amen.
Leave the page blank, say, God,
You tell me
what you want me to do, God. I know you've got a plan, and not only do you have a plan, but you have the power and the ability and the authority to make your plan come to pass. When I'm running around crazy, God, trying to do what I want to do, most time I just look like an idiot and fail. And you have to come get me anyway. So how about I save you the trouble and me? He said, stand still. First, you got to get fear out of the way before you ever stand still. Amen. You better write that down. That's good. You got to get fear out of the way before you will ever stand still. How many people in here were scared of the dark when you was a kid? Did you ever go out in the woods or out at night? You went as fast as you could go, didn't you? Because you was worried that if you stop, something's going to come out and get you. Amen, right? But now, well, I don't know if you're still scared or not, but you grow up, you go stand in the woods all night long, don't bother you. Because you're not worried. You're not scared. We can stand still in the presence of God. There is no fear.
That's right.
We can stand still, Miss Diane, and be willing to accept what's coming.
That's right.
You know what? There may be something in your life this year that you didn't want to do. Amen? Do you know what? Stand still, and the fear will go away. Stand still and see the salvation of the Lord, which he will show to you today. I like this. For the Egyptians, for that thing that you fear, for that thing that's had you in bondage, for that thing that's kept you in a place you didn't want to be, for that thing that has control over you, I'm making a point here, just hang in there till it hits you.
Uh-huh. You shall see no more forever.
You shall see them again, no more.
Amen.
Forever.
That's a long time.
If you go into this new year looking at God, trusting in leaving whatever it was that controlled you, whatever it was stopped you, whatever told you what you could do and what you couldn't do. If you leave that behind and only look forward, you'll never see that problem again. Once they fully come out of Egypt, now you can read on, it took a while. Even though they didn't see it, it was still in them. You read on, and all they do is keep talking about wanting to go back. Every time something bad happened, they want to go back. That sound like a Christian? Can I get an amen? Every time something bad happens, we want to go back. Go back to what? Was life so good then? Life was worse then than it was, than it could ever be now, but yet we want to go back. We think that's so much better. Oh, I ain't never made my own bricks. I ain't never cut my own grass to make them out of it. You know what? I'd rather be walking around eating bread falling from the sky and birds running up to me.
Isn't that the truth?
Amen. Want a drink of water, hit a rock, get some. That's a whole lot better than having to make your own. But see, we got to leave our problems behind. Amen. I got one more scripture and then I'm done.
Yep. Don't leave that out.
Nah. Alright, got your Bible, go to the book of Mark. Chapter 2. Anybody there? Says, no man puts new wine,
amen,
into an old bottle.
That's right.
Amen. I kind of tell you this morning, the old stuff don't fit anymore. This is our first service of the new year. This is our opportunity to get rid of it. Amen. And if we're all honest, everybody in here got something you need to get rid of. Everybody in here has got something old that we want to hold on to.
Yes.
And we want to stick it in the new. We don't feed it. It says, no man put a new wine into old bottles, else the new wine doth burst the bottles. Anything old that you try to put in the new will only cause damage. Amen. It's time to quit looking back.
Yep.
In the words of Elsa All Frozen, it's time to let it go.
Let it go.
Amen. Everybody in here singing that song in your head now, you're welcome. We got to let that stuff go. And there's no better place to let it go than into the arms of Jesus.
Amen.
Jesus will take, hey, that's what I like about Jesus. He will take everything that you give him. Good or bad. Amen. And the wine is spilled, and the bottles will be marred. So you see right there, all that old stuff just causes problems.
Yes, it does.
Too many of us, and notice I said us, have been struggling with the same thing year after year, year after year, year after year, because we keep a little piece of it.
Yep, we do.
And we just keep putting it in and trying to make it fit. Amen. Maybe this is the year that it'll work.
Amen. Praise God.
But new wine must be put into new bottles.
Good word.
This morning, everybody would stand your feet. I'd ask you this morning, the altar's open. Is there something that you need to lay down? Is there something that you need to quit looking at? You know, sometimes it's like we carry a piece around with us and we get it out and look look at it and remember. And in our house, I've got my own room downstairs, my study. I don't ever do a whole lot of studying in there, but I got a bunch of junk. And it's all stuff that reminds me of some part of my life. Whether it's an old Halloween costume I had when I was a kid, to something my great-grandpa made, something my dad left me, Ghostbusters, Goonies, Harry Potter, I got all kinds of stuff. And every now and then, Miss Diane, I'll go in there and look at that stuff.
Yeah.
And it'll take me back to a simpler time.
Amen.
Amen? And there ain't nothing wrong with that. But it's the stuff that's hindering your walk.
That's the stuff.
Now see, I go look at that. I got a Casper Halloween costume. I don't know if y'all remember, they used to be in the boxes and they sold them at Lay's Dollar Store. And it had the old plastic mask and the little plastic thing you put over. And Lord, there's probably about 40 things in there nowadays, probably key. Back in the day, we had them. And I go in there, Chris, and I get that thing, and I look at it, and it just makes me happy. Now, I don't put it on. Number one, it wouldn't fit on a big head, man. But I don't put it on to try to go back to it. I just remember. Too many of us trying to put things on to go back to a place. So this morning, I'd ask you, I'm not going to wait you out, I'm not going to have to sing one more song, I'm not going to lay my Bible across the door, I ain't going to do all that. But this morning is as good a time as any.
To lay it down.
To quit looking back. To take that thing, and everybody knows what I'm talking about, I ain't got to go through a list. To take that thing that stopped you from achieving last year what God had in store for you. And lay it down. Because this is a new year and a new time. So I'd ask you this morning, if that's you, come lay it down. And I'll leave you with this. Don't go back and get it.
Amen.
Allow God to let the waters flow and cover up the way that you come out of it. That way you can't go back.
Amen.